Hello, everybody. Your favorite OCD squirrel in the world, Mikey. And I'm here to bring you some new interesting things. What I've got here is a crayon piece. It's a CFA-1. It's from Austria. Unique place to be. I don't see much audio equipment coming from Austria, but this one does. And it is a unique piece. It has some unique features. It's 28 watts. At 8 ohms, so it's an integrated amp. Clearly, it has an integrated phono pre as well inside there with both MM and MC capability. It's a pretty neat piece, kind of unique. It's got the heat sink that comes right up through the middle of the unit, as you can see. I can't really see in there, but, you know, we can go down in there. That's the heat sink right through the middle, which is pretty cool. See these? We just saw these on the Bridge Audio Labs. It's kind of wild that these have it too, but sort of so you can stack stuff, evidently. And so we're going to listen to this right now. We're going to listen to it with these Sonus Faber bookshelf speakers. These are Minima Vintage, and they're killer. They're reissues of those of the Sonus, like you remember. They've got the leather on the back, the leather on the front. And they have that Dyne Audio tweeter. I think they call it an Esotar, maybe. But it's a killer tweeter. I believe the driver also is like a 5 1/4, maybe. And that, I believe, is also Dyne. Yeah, that's even smaller. That's like a 4 inch, something like that, 4 1/2. Yeah, so nice, dope paper, it looks like. So you can see, it's sort of classic. It's a classic finish with the nice, this... If anybody's seen Chario, it's kind of like these two as well. And then the matching integrated stands, which are killer, really pretty. You can adjust those. And then we're also featuring, here's the Audiobyte, the VOX DAC. Power supply is on the bottom. It's a ultra cap power supply. And then, so it's pretty cool, man, to have a DAC for 4K that has an outboard power supply. The dual chassis type arrangement. Up here is, this is all headphone amp. It's a pretty good headphone amp from what I hear, but I don't listen to headphones. And then we've got our DAC board here, which is pretty cool. I mean, those are 4 discrete buffers, you know, no op amps in here, which is cool. It's cool when they do that, man. They take the extra time and effort to not put, you know, chips for the output. They use those discrete buffers, which is pretty cool. Anyway, so that's a cool piece. And, I think this is one's discontinued. So it's a little bit older, $3,500. This is $4,000, for those two. And then these are, man, I can't remember what they are retail. I'm selling them for $2,500 for the pair. And that's what we're listening to. Again, nothing else in the chain. None of this other stuff. There's only these pieces. The DAC, the integrated, and the Sonus Faber. We've got no subs or anything in here. We're just going to listen to it the way it is. So, I'm going to go back over here. And we will give it a little listen to. And see, it's been a long time since we've listened to a small little baby rig like this. But they are pretty cool as well, and I definitely dig this little arrangement. So let's see if we can get, that's too close. Okay, here I am. Nope, that's too far. Okay, here we go. So again, we're listening to these two speakers, this DAC, and this integrated. That's it. Nothing else in the chain, except for the server back there. And that's just my same one, my home build. So here we go.
People on the road are getting nowhere.
switch it up a little bit here. I'm gonna try and find something other than rock. Let's see. You hear that? Killer though. I love that thing, man. I don't know what it is about that. I don't have any Scandinavian in my blood that I know of, but something about that tune strikes me to my core, man. It's like, it's something about it. It's I believe that it's a Nordic, it's a Viking warrior, and he's singing, he's at like, I don't know if he's weary from war, and he's like, you know, he's singing to his creator, I believe. Like, and he's standing at the gates of hell or heaven or what have you. It's like, you know, I don't know. It's pretty ethereal to me, you know. They've got this really cool, this band is called Wardruna, W-A-R-D-R-U-N-A. And if you go to YouTube and you type in Wardruna Helvegen, H-E-L-V-E-G-E-N, I believe this is the song that they're standing in front of this. They're outside in front of this huge cave entrance, and it's like a natural amphitheater. And my God, dude, it's so moving. It's just like brings me to tears when I hear it. It's unbelievably strong and powerful. It's like, holy shit, man, what the hell? Serious, serious folk music that just strikes you to the core of your being as a human. You know, it's intense how folk can do that sometimes, you know. It can just really bring you to your humanness or your animalness, I guess. But whatever it is, it moves me very much, and I really appreciate it. So let's see, let's try something other, a little bit on our little baby system here, and then I'm gonna get lost. So let's see, where was I? I thought I saw Johnny Cash. Oh, we got Vivaldi. I should do that for some of the guys. I know y'all want it. Let's see. Let me go back there. Four Seasons. Let's see what this is all about. What we got here. ¶¶ so I got to put this on the big rig just to, if it's quick and easy enough, because I don't want to have too much work here. But okay, so that is definitely a big rig piece of music. Okay, and what I'll tell you what immediately I hear from that is it rolled off like that violin that's going. That thing needs to have a leading edge on it that pierces through the air and goes direct to your eardrum, and it's like a tuning fork. It just kind of tunes you up. You're just like, what? You know, this does not have that. So it's the speakers, most likely have a soft dome tweeter. A combination. It's the speakers that are not letting. If we put some small magnetpans or something like that, ribbon type, we would get all that high frequency. So just realize what I said. You can go back and listen to how there is not a leading edge. And that is the difference. Not having the leading edge and having the leading edge is the difference between real and not real. Because real life has a total leading edge on any sound. If you clap your hands near somebody, they're going to jump. There's a really dynamic, high-pitched, high-frequency, you know, sharp, striking, you know, startling leading edge, and that's life. And so when you have that in your music and you have it on your audio rig, it mimics real life and it sounds like real life, and you are convinced that it is. When it's rolled off a little teeny bit, to be polite or whatever it is, maybe, you know, like we just heard, it's just very, very obviously you're hearing recorded something. Doesn't sound the way it does. It does not sound the way it would if a violin was over there and they were playing it. It would sound way different, you know? So that's kind of what we're in the pursuit of. Anyways, want to give you a little taste of this little baby rig, because I know I don't feature them very often. And thought I'd give you a little taste of something we were testing right now, just playing around with. And so there you have it. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you. Okay, as I told you, we're going to listen to Vivaldi on the big rig. Thank you. dig so much of that stuff.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, so cool. Anyway, so you got a feeling there for what the big rig did with a little orchestral music, and I want to get back to some down and dirty, so we'll talk to you later. See you.